Welcome, Kevin, to the show.
Thank you for having me.
It's nice having you the second time in the show.
Thank you.
And actually, this is my fourth episode, and I'll be uploading online.
Interesting.
We're going to speak about Flutter development.
Sure.
And we're going to share some experiences that you have seen since using it, since scratch, and actually being able to develop something that will impact the society. So our first question will be, what is it like to be a Flutter developer?
So I think personally for me, being a Flutter developer is quite interesting. For me, I love it because I can build beautiful apps really fast. So for me, I really love it. And I'm still learning.
Is very interesting. Learning is always something, it's continuing over and over.
Yeah, it's continuous.
So you're going to do something different. Also, sure. I'm going to ask about something. How do I start now to now use Flutter?
So I assume you mean installation.
Very good.
The start of
the setup.
So ideally to start off with Flutter,
mm-hmm.
everything is online,
mm-hmm.
As is the norm these days. So if you go to Flutter's official page, it has documentation on how to start off with the installation process. If you're on Mac, if you're on Windows, it has instructions for that as well. So in terms of the IDEs you might want to use, there are different IDEs. The mostly used ones are Android Studio and Visual Studio Code. Personally for me, I use Visual Studio Code. But it's quite an easy process to set up the environment and everything.
Yeah, that is very nice. And also I'm excited to ask this. What was it like to now write the Hello World? The feeling, the excitement of it.
So ideally for me, I think because I'm usually result oriented,
okay,
I really loved writing my first code and seeing it work. So my first experience writing my first code was a bit it was a new feeling, writing in a new language, a new framework, and seeing the results come to life. But for me as well, it was a beautiful feeling and I loved it. It was actually really easy. The learning curve for me was a bit easy starting off, because ideally for me, I think the learning curve was really easy starting off, but now it really goes in, grows in complexity as you progress. But it was really easy and good.
Really interesting. And you as a Flutter developer, as you're giving kind of advice now to the naive or the person who's beginning to now learn about Flutter, what are the best factors somebody can consider in terms of using it?
So I think in terms of best factors, mm-hmm. we are leaning on advantages,
mm-hmm.
and Flutter does have some advantages, and one which really impresses me is one code base, and then you deploy to multiple platforms. So with Flutter you can write a single code base and deploy your app on either iOS, Android, a desktop app or a web app. So that's really a plus for me. Another plus for me is that it really builds fast apps, beautiful apps as well. And that's something I really love. And you can also use it for embedded applications as well. Yeah, or devices. Yeah.
That is very, very interesting. Sure. So actually those are key elements. And also to add what you just said, is something about accessibility.
Yeah.
Because you have said it's targeting a very wide operating system.
Sure.
Kind of Linux, Mac OS, and Windows.
Yeah.
It's actually targeting a very large variety of groups.
Yeah.
I'm actually going about something else. For example, I'm assuming I'm a Flutter developer. I'm not into Flutter, for example. Sorry. I'm an Android developer, and I'm having a skill set in Android, and I'm feeling like I need now to migrate into Flutter. Not learn the framework and use my other skill in Flutter. How does Flutter basically accommodate me as an Android developer?
So to answer that question,
mm-hmm.
ideally Flutter,
mm-hmm.
Flutter is built on top of the Dart programming language. And as you know, programming languages, they only differ in terms of syntax mostly, or the programming paradigm. But in terms of the concepts, they are really the same all across. So sequencing, iteration, all that, classes, all that, if you're doing OOP languages. So transitioning from another language in Android or iOS development into Dart using the Flutter framework is really easy, and there are actually tools out there for you to have a look or to guide you through the transition process. Yeah,
that is very fantastic. And sure. Because I've said now the transition is very easy. Now you as a React developer now or an Android developer, you can just migrate into it and actually get know the concept and just deploy your app using Flutter. And we're going to talk about something very interesting. This is a very fundamental part of coding. It's about development cycle. So we're going to speak about the cycle in terms of Flutter. So the first question is, in terms of GUI and its building block, what was it like? Is it about writing the code into that particular frames or just dragging and drop element into in terms of text block or images? How is it about?
So for Flutter, I haven't quite seen a tool built for drag and drop.
Okay.
So mostly you have to write code.
Okay.
And that's using the Dart programming language.
Okay.
And basically the building blocks of Flutter are what we call widgets.
Okay.
So everything that you see on your screen, be it a button, be it a text, is a widget.
Very good.
So the app is made up of a widget tree with different widgets, having different functionalities, and each widget having either state in case an app changes, or it can lack state as well, depending on how it functions within the application.
Okay, that is very interesting. The idea of widgets, isn't it?
Sure.
Very good, because if you go to the website, the flutter.dev, it just says building beautiful apps, the idea of behind the GUI, the graphical user interface. After now you've now developed or created that particular GUI, you're going to speak about the data and the back end of it. In terms of data storage, how is it like in Flutter?
So in terms of data storage, I think we have two options. So I think the first option that's usually run into by new developers in that field is what we call backend as a service. And one of the most advocated for tools for that has been Firebase by Google. So Firebase gives you a functionality for a database, authentication, machine learning, and all that right off the bat. So it takes the development work of the backend off your hands. But for this first option, I think it's usually more suited for people who don't want to do like too much development work on the backend. And it's also suitable for apps that are really small and that aren't going to scale that big. So the second option on that is what we call you creating your own APIs using any language that you might want to use. And the advantage of that is that it can be used for big apps that scale quite a mile. Yeah.
Actually, something very crucially actually touched about the idea of machine learning AI into database. One of the major things a company are looking into. And that only actually create an exciting thing about me in terms of, because I leverage most in data.
Yeah.
So the interest now, the scope grows so wide. So even tomorrow I'll now start using it.
Yeah, sure.
So we're going to do something on a different angle because we already spoken about accessibility. But you're going to just talk about it shortly in a brief. So in terms of accessibility and platform integration, what can you say about the Flutter?
So having the ability to deploy to multiple platforms really gives you as a developer quite a good reach. So you can write one app that has the same feel if you transition to the web app or the desktop environment or the mobile environment. So it gives you a really good reach in case you want greater accessibility to your client base or to your user base, that is.
Okay, that is very, very interesting. And there's something about platform. I think adding Flutter to existing platforms. Sure. I think I've spoken about it, but you can just in a brief.
Yeah, so... Mm-hmm. Flutter can be embedded. I haven't quite tried it yet, but you can embed it. You can import it to other apps or other code as a library function and have it, let's say, display some functionality on your existing app, but as a library. So I think that's a capability that's really good in case you want a particular part of your software or app to be built in Flutter. Yeah.
Actually, that is very interesting because in the current world, there's no need of now building things from the scratch.
Sure.
Calling packages, embedding things, one of the exciting things about software development.
Exactly.
And there's something very crucial now because you're spoken about the entire cycle. There's something about testing and debugging in Flutter. How is it done and how is it like?
So testing is made a bit easier by testing and debugging tools. This can either be provided by the development environment or the IDE you're using. So for me, VS Code has debugging tools that are usually key. In terms of other tools as well, they are what we call Dart dev tools. So they help you debug your code as well. And some of these tools can be embedded. I actually embedded in browsers such as Google Chrome, whereby you can test your app, let's say widget by widget or line by line. Yeah, so testing is quite heavy, and there's some good assistance for you as a developer. So, yeah.
Very interesting. And actually, we have talked about the introduction part of Flutter and actually sure. Talk about development. So the question which comes now,
yeah.
How long did it take you now to learn the concept of Flutter?
So I really can't say I've learned like the whole concept of Flutter,
mm-hmm.
but learning the basics didn't quite take me long.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say like a month or so mm-hmm. to learn the basics, that is.
Okay.
Even now, before delving into other complex subjects such as state management and all that, but learning the basics was a bit easy. So, and that's why I said earlier that the learning curve was a bit easy at the start, and then as you grow, it becomes a bit complex. But it's I think it's nothing you can't handle. Yeah,
I think there's a very basic concept in IT or in programming. There's something about iteration. Once you do something over and over, it becomes easy to do it.
Sure.
I think anyone watching this can now get a very, very interesting start and actually creating some apps and becoming a Flutter developer.
Sure.
So we're going to do something different. The last part of it, it's about the motivation. It's one of the key aspects of Created Podcast. You want to see how, in terms of changes you're doing in the society. So the question is, you as a Flutter developer, how can you advise the young developer in terms of being efficient in the lines of code?
So I think as a Flutter developer or any other type of developer,
uh-huh.
Just make your code simple. Don't do too much.
Mm-hmm.
Just do what's required.
Mm-hmm.
Don't overclutter your app. Just make it simple
mm-hmm.
and make it readable. Maybe you have to write comments and all that
mm-hmm.
for other developers who might want to jump in as well
okay. And
have a look at them.
Mm-hmm.
So just make it simple. Make it simple mm-hmm. and make it work as well.
Okay.
You can create apps that don't work mm-hmm. either for you
mm-hmm.
or for the people around you
mm-hmm.
or for the world at large. So mm-hmm. make it simple and try and make it work.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sure.
And that actually marks the end of the session. And I'm very, very excited to have you in my episode 4.
I'm also thankful to be here.
And I'm hoping in the future we shall have more shows and more exciting development shows. So as we are ending, what is your check, the last bit of it?
The last bit is like, subscribe, share,
mm-hmm.
and code with Flutter.
Oh, fantastic. A word from Kevin. He's one of my friends in software. And actually, he shares one of his fantastic interests and knowledge and actually what you can gain from him and actually can inspire you to become the Flutter developer. And actually, thank you for watching and actually subscribe and become the family of the Created Podcast as we invite more people who will inspire your life and actually create a possible solution in your life. Thank you and see you.